Another data type that we can import into an Access database is called a text file. A text file is also called an ASCII file or a comma delimited or a CSV. It's a really popular data type. It's just a plain unformatted data file. Most software programs can generate a text file that we can import into Access. So in this case, I'm going to pick on external data again, and we're going to pick on text file. Now, once again, you have this kind of screen. So an import is going to make a new table in your Access database that'll be independent of the original source. When we append it, it's going to take the records from the text file and append it to an existing Access table. Or we can also link it, which means if the text file changes, the Access database will also change. In this case, I'll pick on import. We're going to pick on browse. So now you're going to go to the folder that came with the book as far as the files. And I'll pick on this one that's called leads. You can see it's a text document. We'll pick on open. And we'll pick on OK on this window. Now, a text file can either be delimited or fixed width. A delimited file means that the fields are separated by some kind of character. Maybe it's a comma or a space or a semicolon or something like that between each field. Fixed width means the data is always consistent. Maybe the first field is over here and the second field is over here and so on. However, if it were to be fixed width, you would see nice even columns of data on this screen. When you don't see nice even columns of data, you can be pretty sure it's delimited. By the way, if you're using a CSV data type, then that is delimited, and the C means comma. A CSV file is always comma delimited. So I'll pick on next. Now you want to tell what it's delimited by. It looks like this one is going to be by a tab because now we have nice even columns of data. If you're not sure which one it is, let's try the different ones. Let's try semicolon. Nothing happened there. Nothing for comma. Nothing for space. Now with space, something happened, but it wasn't as good as with tab. So you can see in this case, it looks like it's a tab. Sometimes it's a different character. You would pick an other there, but I would say like 80 or 90% of the time, it's one of these top four. Now also, if you notice, my first row contains my field names, so I want to make sure you check that box. Very important. All right, so it's usually one of those top four. If you don't know which one it is, you would just guess. You know, you would just try the different ones and guess like we did here. I know you're looking for a more profound answer from me, but that's what I do. I go through them until I find the right one. Clearly, in this case, it's a tab. Okay, so we'll pick on next. Now, you could change the field names if you wanted to. What you would do is you would click on each field, and then you can change the field name of that field as it's going to appear in the Access database. You can make it an indexed field. You can change the data type. And you can also not even import that field at all. So you can do that field by field when you need to. Many times the field names that are there are just fine. So I'll pick on next. Now here's talking about the primary key. So we can either let Access add the primary key, which is gonna add one of those auto number fields, as we see here. We can choose our own primary key, you know, like a social security number would be a primary key, something that's going to be unique for each record, or we can say no primary key. In this case, I'm going to say let Access add the primary key, and you can see it adds one of those auto numbers in there. I'll pick on next. You want to give a table a name. We'll call this one leads, and it already has that, and we'll pick on finish. Now it says it imported that table successfully. Now, if you wanted to save the import steps, here's why you would do that. Let's say you're going to import that same text file in the future. If you save the import steps, it'll reduce the wizard down to one or two steps instead of going through that whole routine again. So if you think that you are going to import that in the future, I might recommend that you save your import steps. At this point, I'm going to pick on close. Notice how we have a new table that's called leads, and it's like any other table, except we were able to import that in from a text file. The way we did that was we picked on external data and we said text file and then just followed the screens from there.